Your Highness, you have attended these events many times in the past. What is the significance of the National Prayer Breakfast?
It's a wonderful opportunity that was started under President Eisenhower more than 60 years ago. And it gathers every state of the United States, and this time over 130 countries. And for breakfast this morning, there are close to 4,000 people. And everybody gets together, and it's based on the principles of Jesus. It brings everybody together, but the respect of all religions. It's absolutely amazing to see so many different people from different walks of life.
What does your participation today mean for Serbia, your actual presence here at the prayers breakfast?
It means a lot, and I think one should stress the opportunity to meet people. I just came this time from a lunch with the Southeastern European representatives, and you have the whole lot from our region, the Balkans, as you might say. And these are former prime ministers, members of parliament, everything you can imagine. And everybody gets on very well. They're friendly, they hug each other, they want to talk more, and they have their prayer breakfasts in each capital. We have one in Belgrade, there's one in Tirana, there's one in Podgorica, there's all sorts of things. And to see this friendship and exchange of interest is so positive. So in this hotel every year there is much more understanding between certainly our peoples of our region and beyond with all the other peoples of the world. And the horrors that have happened just a few days ago are very apparent, and everybody's feeling very, very strong about it. So President Obama even spoke about it today. So for everybody to hear this, 130 nationalities to hear this, brings people closer on this very small planet that we live.
What are the topics most discussed at the prayers meeting and among the international delegates, and what is the importance of it?
The topics are multi ones. For example, development, education. Education was one of the big ones. How to maintain people not to leave the country. And creating jobs came then. So if you want to keep the young people, and we certainly have a big problem in Serbia, of close to 20,000 people who receive their diplomas leaving the country, you have to have investors. So that was discussed too. And also visitation of people from other countries. Many people here would like to come and visit us because they made friends, and we're lucky to have a place where they can meet. And we've done that before in bringing a few congressmen, a few leaders, a few members of parliament, and others. So you have this networking. I think the big word is network.
What are the next events that you plan to attend during your current US visit?
Well, it's a very good question that my wife with her foundation, humanitarian foundation called Lifeline, has organized with her wonderful people four events in the United States. First one is in St. Petersburg, and the second one is in Miami. That's on the West Coast, on the East Coast. And then we're going to go to the West Coast where we have an event in Los Angeles and in San Marcos, just south. And the purpose of these events is to help the serious situation that our people find themselves in. For example, we have outbreaks of cancer, we have lacks of equipment, we need specialized medicine. Another very important point is to bring people over to the United States for training, to bring them up to date with the latest technology. And my wife, through her connections, has organized this in Houston, Texas, in New York, and other places. So this is our major point of our trip after this Washington visitation.
Thank you very much, Your Highness.
Thank you. It's a great pleasure.